Big Trouble. Big Trouble Podcast, where we purposely trying to get into some trouble.
Hey man, it's your whole season.
It's Ken Wynn.
Kevo the show, man.
Episode 20, we bike, we live, man.
Episode 20, man.
We got 20 of them things with y'all.
Hey, like, comment, subscribe, man.
Hey man, y'all got my partner keep saying that every week.
Nah,
can y'all just do what my boy's saying?
Yeah. I'm seeing the likes. I'm seeing our likes.
But I'm
go
seeing
up.
3-4 people, bro.
3-4 comments.
We can have more people come in and it just, hey, that was fire.
Nah, they scared that y'all didn't go get on their ass, bro.
I'm going to come back the next episode and I'm answer 133.
Yeah, they can hear you going to say the wrong shit to me, bro.
But everybody that's rocking with us, keep rocking with us, man.
Facts.
We a dub in, man.
We dub in. We getting there.
They said it was 10 to get in. We put up 20, man. Straight up.
They said we wasn't going to be out of 10. That's what I heard.
Hey, but guess what? We finna get banned after dub. I'm going to tell you that right now. I'm going for it.
I'm shooting for today. I'm with my boy today.
I'm with my boy today.
Nah,
fuck it. What we talking about, man?
What y'all boys got, man?
So when we dropped the extendo, we left out with Houston. I told my boy to save it because that's a live topic that we need to go ahead and tackle because he was.
Oh yeah, when I was talking about Houston, yeah. Ain't Houston and no more. Yeah, right. Bro, like the city ain't giving you that feel, bro. You know we always had. It's kind of like this bitch was a hidden gem. Niggas ain't know how good we was living down. Even though when you told them, they didn't expect Houston to be like it is, right? But in the past few years, I say during that COVID era, everything changed down here. Mm-hmm. You pull up to the club, bro, they charge you like out of town niggas.
Yeah, facts.
You 100 before you even get in the club,
bro. It's 60 the park, and you buy 60 at the door, 40 at the door. Yeah, you're right about the
door. Yeah. 40 and 60.
Yeah.
Like you on the Vegas strip.
Yeah, you be like, nigga, what the fuck, nigga? Mm-hmm. The fuck? Like, what kind of shit is that? The bottles, bro. Like, the bottles, bro. What they charge
the section. A section, bro. I seen somebody say they spend, like, $3,500 on a section.
Yeah, you go to the right club, for sure.
$3,500?
If somebody, they got somebody there.
Yeah. On a regular night, I was looking at the bottles. Man, they had a bottle of 818 for $485. Like, God damn, 818? Like, God damn. This is what we coming to now. It's Houston and turned to Miami and L.A. and New York.
Yeah. But it's like you said, during that pandemic area, it's like we was in Atlanta was the only ones open. So they got to come feel our culture. But they taking the culture back with them. It was like, hey, this was going down in Houston.
Let's go. This bitch ass TikTok.
Yeah, and TikTok.
TikTokers. Yeah. Come to Houston. A weekend in Houston, man. Y'all got to go check it. Nigga, it's the same shit been going down. Mm-hmm. Now y'all done drove our motherfucking prices through the roof. You used to get a mini mansion down here for $500.
We're 100 extra now.
Yeah.
100,000.
Yeah.
I'm looking at my eyes, 385 now.
Yeah.
Nah, that wasn't what it was.
Yeah, for real, bro. That wasn't what it was, man.
Real, bro.
Man, you, bro, before COVID, nigga, you was able to get you a 2-story, nice 4-bedroom house, bro. Bro, that hoe was still in the one.
By two,
that was 100-something.
By 224.
Depends on where you was at. You can still pay 180.
So my question is, I need to do some research, bro. So is this in every live city? Do you think everything?
Nigga. Because you'll see this shit if you go to New York, everything's sky high. You go to Miami, everything's sky high. LA, everything's gone because they big cities and all the tourists. This tourist,
but yeah,
they turn this bitch into that.
Once the population go up, the numbers go up,
and that's why I was, you know, ours was always it was out, not up. Now our shit going up, and I'm talking about as far as bill wise, you get space.
Yeah.
Now you get stacked up. Yeah. All they doing is laying. Nigga, we just started seeing 3-story.
Nah, I don't
businesses.
Like that. We land type niggas, bro.
Yeah.
In Texas, we land.
Now we got 3-4-story. Look like brownstone buildings and shit all over Houston. That shit ain't never looked like this, bro. The only way you had seen that shit was over there at what was that? Like Midtown? Yeah, that was it.
What I don't like about it is the club scene, bro. Like, the club ain't clubbing no more, bro. Ain't no more coming in there, getting behind bitches, dancing. Everything's sectional.
Everything designed it out.
Because you gotta be.
Well, I wouldn't dance with a hoe if I'm coming in my fit 2500. Three racks. Yeah. I ain't for the dance with you.
And then this section, so if I'm in the section and if I see a nice little bitch I like, she in the whole section, I gotta, excuse me, let me get, you gotta go through all that just to get that.
Then when she get up in there, she expecting it to be more than what it is. We got two bottles. She want to drink that bottle by herself, like, y'all ain't passing these bars around?
They don't want you to buy them drink no more. They want you to send a bottle.
Send a bottle.
Yeah.
Ace of spades. That's
why I'm like Slim Thug, bro. I'm still a nigga that's gonna go to the bar, bro.
I'm a bar type nigga too.
I'm going to the bar.
I spent $200 at the bar.
Me too. I don't give a fuck.
I am just that wild, bro. Like,
and there's still a lot of drinks.
But you can tell though, it's out of town is because I seen some shit C posted earlier. The Carol's nigga. Nobody even talk about Carol's, bro. Like, that was all popping spot. Like, to go have a good time, a cheap time, you can tell out of town took over. Now the Houstonians want to go where they going.
Yeah.
We need to go back to Carol's.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, bro.
Carol's great again.
Nah, wait, bro. I ain't gonna lie. I went to Sleepy's, bro, and I just slid in Carol's to get a drink waiting on my food, bro. That shit was like, I'm like, I see why we don't go here no more.
It was
just fat bitches and retarded niggas up in there. I seen niggas gangbang. I'm like, nah. Seen the nigga stacking, Chris. I say, I see why we don't go here no more, bro. This shit out of whack.
But we tired of the shit.
I see the slabs on flat. Slabs on flat in front of nigga high with dust on them. I'm like, man, what's happening to Houston? Niggas ain't in there. Niggas is riding them Uber Blacks now. Everybody want to jump out the Tahoe with the Escalade. You know what I'm saying?
I want to try.
In the slab, niggas writing their names in them and shit. Damn, Houston fucked up. It's ain't Houston no more, bro.
Shit. I mean, but Houston, we been live, bro. So it was only a matter of time for everybody to migrate here.
But then
and steal the culture, bro, and like they been doing.
But they
you steal the culture and take it back. Don't stay here, bro. Don't stay here. We know, shit, bro.
Yeah.
Cause they did that shit to a city that I like to go to as well as Dallas, bro.
They took over Dallas too, bro. Dallas, Austin, Vegas, Austin, Silicon Valley, they took Austin. They live like this. I love Austin, bro. I love Austin, the view. But you see, this is the thing. Bro, y'all remember, but we went from having 5 o'clock traffic to all day traffic.
It's all day, dog.
Yeah, I be pissed off because I'm like, bro, it's 10 o'clock and it's 10 a.m. How am I in traffic?
Yeah.
Y'all motherfuckers ain't at work or nothing. The kids at school, how is it traffic?
Because these young punks down here, TikTokers, and enough motherfuckers that's just walking down the street, I ain't got no money. They got the Lambo right there. They making a prank on a female.
Yeah.
I ain't got no money.
I'll catch one. You nigga, get your bitch ass from over here, bro. Real talk, my nigga. We don't do that type of shit down here, bro. Bitch ass.
Hey, this episode 20.
The crazy thing is because I be seeing them niggas go live, they be in Houston. And if I catch one of them hoes that I know doing the videos, I'm...
Get out of here. You know
me on. Why you shaking it? What you break my swag? Is it a 10?
Yeah,
it's a 10. Man, get your
bag. Man, ran the bag up off of that.
Yeah, he did.
I know he did. But let somebody else did, they've been a pervert.
But I guarantee that nigga ain't from Houston.
Nah, I don't think so.
He ain't from Houston, bro.
I don't think so. I'm sick
of them niggas, bro.
Because we not, like, bro, anytime you, if you go in and put in a Houston nigga, create your Houston nigga on NBA 2K or something. First of all, nigga gonna be laid back.
Yeah, cool.
He's not doing all that jumping in the face. Second of all, he player. So I'm not all in a bitch face. Wow. Is he gonna do it? Clap. Nah, I'm not doing all
check
that.
Check out my feet. How much you think this? Nah, we ain't doing all that.
We player out here. We in a bitch with that shit on, bro. Let me see. You at least a 9.
Get this nigga 9 if you don't get your rainbow dressing ass.
It be the whole dressed in them fashion house ass dresses. Yeah. Let me see.
10.
You got like a 10. Man, shut the fuck up.
He red jeans, red fire.
Make Carol's great again.
Bring the mascot back in there, that nigga.
Yeah,
that vibrator.
Cause that man, bro, that man.
That nigga that always come.
He's a treasure,
that's
bro.
That's the mascot.
Oh, this how we doing our with the picture you go post after this. We doing it like this, bro. We showing that nigga some love, bro.
I'm gonna have him on the podcast, yeah, bro.
You gotta bring him on here, bro. He's a legend.
He's a legend, bro. He's a
street
legend.
Real talk, man.
But I feel what you're saying 100%. I ain't that Houston shit. It is kind of dead, bro.
Yeah, they feel so. I'm ready to go. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I ain't gonna lie. I'm ready to get up out of here.
But the thing is, as soon as you leave, you're going to be ready to come back.
Hell nah, yeah. I'm coming back on weekends or something. I ain't going to go. I'm going, like, to the outskirts.
Oh, yeah. Okay. You
talking about, like, the,
I don't say nothing. But I'm going to say it because they're going to start following out there. They already starting. It ain't no rules, so they already starting to hit the outskirts. Nah, bro. Yeah, yeah. No.
I'm seeing them in Katy. I'm,
bro. All you see is Ohio, Illinois, California. Florida, that's all the plates you see.
I'm not gonna lie, I was at a store, bro, out there in the outskirts somewhere. I seen Funny Mike and them out there.
Yeah, I seen them out there in Katy.
Bro, I'm.
Yeah.
In that scrimmage.
Yeah.
Jumping out, bro. Like, I'm like, bro, y'all goofy ass niggas.
I seen them in Katy, y'all.
Nigga on Parker Row X.
With a bunch of ruins. They, you know, it's a lot of land out there in Katy, man. You know.
That's where it's popping in right now.
It's dead out there, y'all.
Hey, listen, bro. Sharon is untouched land. That land is unclaimed.
Oh, that shit's so stupid and racist. Y'all need to be out there.
Nah, for real though, bro.
Nah, I want to get into some more shit though. You right. I ain't gonna lie. That shit hit, bro. Because I be feeling that shit. But I want to ask you boys a quick question though. If God say, hey, I'm going to let you go back and come back to your timeline, or I'm going to let you go forward and come back to your timeline, which one would you pick?
What you mean, go back or go forward for what?
Like, you just going back to you can change, or you can fuck with some shit and then come back, or go to the future to fuck with some shit and come back. Which one would you do?
I'm scared of that future. I'm going back.
Because yeah, if I go to, nigga, I tell you, if I go to that future,
what if they go black, I'm dead. What if I'm dead, bro?
He go to the future and then.
I'm bro.
That's what I was saying.
Boy, you got shot 5 years ago, bro. Your ass out there.
I was just saying, bro. The niggas go bars, bro. Yeah. I'm on the floor at the store. I'm big bro. Let nigga get some. Man, hell nah, nigga. What?
Yeah, I'm going back to pick some shit.
See that future, bro? You out there. Been in a coma for 6 years, nigga. Nah.
I'm gonna say if I can know that my future gonna be.
Nah, you can't.
You can't.
You got to go. Whatever happens.
This one, I'm asking you.
You ain't got no legs or something.
Okay. The second thing is, I know because I'll pick back too. Because if you go to the future and say like, hey, you look on the thing, we only got 2 more years left. So now I gotta come back and know we got 10 years left.
You know when you're dying and shit.
Yeah. I'm like, bro, hold on, the world ended in 10 years.
Yeah.
Nah,
instead of trying to tell everybody,
I'm working.
They get your 1,000 order, young man. I saw you on one of them pages.
They and lost it, bro.
You standing looking at your body, you seen them fat in the future. You like, bro, I don't think you should eat that, bro. He don't know what you talking about. Hey, bro, don't eat that shit, bro. Put it down.
Nah, but the second part of it, like, what would you change?
Like, if I went back?
Yeah.
I don't think I fuck with nothing. Because if I fuck with something in the past, it's going to alter the future, bro. I come back. Let's say if I alter something back there, and then I got to come back to me right now, something's going to be different. Mm-hmm. I got half a head or something. With the war. I'm an old war veteran. Nah, I ain't fucking with nothing, bro. I'm leaving all that shit alone, bro.
I think I'll go ahead and tamper with them lottery numbers. I'm going to go and tamper with them lottery numbers and make sure I hit at a certain point of time or something. I don't know.
So what if we go back? You can it's like everything on pause and you going back in there and fuck with shit on your own?
Yeah, and you coming back. That's what I mean. Like you going, you get to go fuck with some shit. But like
this, you go change the lottery numbers then come back to the future, you doing life and
yeah, that's what I'm saying.
See what I'm saying?
No, I'm saying like I agree with that too. Like you know for every
you know
how the way the universe works.
Yeah,
it's evolving like you fuck up some shit. I gotta pull from here and pull from there.
Yeah.
So you might hit the lottery, but your family gonna get that money. You spend a life in jail.
Yeah. A nigga might kill your ass over the money. You the win.
Yeah.
But I go back there just to go back. If I had the choice, I ain't going forward though. Yeah. I don't want to know.
I did miss out on the little PPP bread. I wish I could go back and get that little 20 band. Yeah. That ain't nobody go to jail for. And I was like,
that nigga went digging through the apps and put his shit on top. Yeah, and bro. Put it through.
Yeah, put my shit through, bro. Ain't nobody go to jail, bro. I'm about to do some little bullshit.
For real, like I'm that, getting bro. The whole 30. I want the grant and I want
I want everything. Yeah. Two dubs and I want all that shit, bro.
Yeah, I'm gonna fuck with my teeth on some real shit.
I was just thinking about that.
I gotta
go
fuck with my teeth a lot. I spend a lot of time.
Yeah, if you can alter it, that means like I'd probably just give my mom a whole new try to alter a whole lifestyle, like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. As far as like if it was cancer based, so I'm gonna just be like, hey man, maybe we should eat better, let's work out, let's do this. I'd alter some shit like that. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying, and see how it play out. It's the same outcome as you when you come back.
It's you dead.
But you spent all that time though.
Yeah, thanks.
Because that's the shit we take for granted. Like we take a lot of the time for granted, and that's another shit that I was talking about. We take our relationships for granted.
Yeah.
Not only like it's like your significant other, your friendships, your parents. You just take a lot of relationships for granted. So you saying that, you spending a lot of time with your mama, like. That we took it for granted back then, like when they was here, like, I was spending some time on my, but not like that.
Yeah.
No, I was too busy trying to come up.
Yeah, we trying to make it. I mean,
that's
life.
Part of life. Yeah, that's part of life, bro. Yeah. That's part of life. Like, you gotta grow into your own person, bro.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So, if you'd have spent every second, well, it still would have felt like you didn't spend enough.
Yeah.
You're gonna want more. You feel what I'm saying? But in the essence of our, like, I think even with, like, that shit, it's how I look at it. It's possible, like on some real shit. But I don't think it's possible to go back. But I think it's possible to change some shit. Like, but it have to be like something that could defy what we call time.
Mm-hmm.
Like as far as like speed wise, like you know what I'm saying. You could easily like let's say you know how time exists to us. It'd be like damn, that's an hour. If it's something that can move so quick in between, you can alter some shit nobody would never know.
It's like a time lapse or a parallel type of universe.
Moving in between time lapse. Yeah, because it's time to us, but to them it's more like, if I did that shit, you could just, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but we ain't got that type of technology, but it's possible.
They need to go and let them aliens land, not to get too big.
Man, them aliens looking at niggas, they ill.
Dumb.
They ill. Check out, bro. Go back to... When they come, they probably Antarctica. You know what I'm saying? They ain't coming to fuck with us, bro.
They ain't fucking with them niggas, bro.
Them dirty-ass people, dog. Oh, they still talking about black and white and shit.
For real, them niggas idiots.
Yeah, hell
no. Nah, real shit, but yeah, I got to take a shot to that kid. Okay. That nigga got me emotional. Yeah, I'm emotional on episode 20.
Well, we just speaking about that, it's like you say, in them young times, bro, we still were trying to find us. Trying to get our shit together, bro. You know, I can't say we can just be all up on our mama like that. Trying to spend more time. But as in this age right now, I feel like this would be the time we'd be like, man, it's time to spend more time with T, bro. Like,
Kev, if I could go back, bro, and I had that time, bro, I would have had my mama on the road with me truck driving.
That's right now.
Get your funky ass on that road. Get your funky ass on the
trap. No, that's right now. That's what I'm saying.
Get your funky ass out the trap and come on the road.
That's right now.
See, bitch, I'm getting off a K-pack a day. you think I'm gonna get out of the trap?
Waste my time.
But that's I do want to get that game to a lot of niggas that's in their 30s, bro, and their mamas up there in the 50s and 60s, bro. Spend more time with your teeth, bro.
You know
what I mean? Even if it's once a week, take your mama out
to
eat.
Stop thinking you got. Stop thinking tomorrow coming, bro. Bro, no. It's not gonna keep being a tomorrow every day, bro.
Right. That's why I say taking relationships for granted.
Yeah.
That's key. Like, nigga, value each and every relationship, no matter who it is. If you fuck with that person, you say you love that person, treat that person some. Don't be dismissive to your relationship. Oh, like, nah, I'll do that shit tomorrow. I'll patch that shit up with that nigga tomorrow. We arguing tonight. Nah, nigga, before we even lay down and we go to sleep, hey, bro, whatever we was into. I apologize, bro.
Yeah,
my bad, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Let me.
Nah,
I'm gonna say it's men.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna say as men. That's easy for us to do. You know, we it is. We used to be like, put that shit to the side, but you know, on the other end, it's gonna be some. I ain't trying to hear that shit.
That's how they
move,
bro.
Who are
they? What we talking about?
You know what he talking about. You know, he, I know. But I'm just saying, like, we very forgiveful, thoughtful motherfuckers, bro.
Yeah. Because you understand. Yeah. Everything, we put everything into perspective. Be like, man, shit, we
done. Yeah,
nah, I know what could happen between now and in the morning. I can get that call and say, bro, die in his sleep. Like, what the fuck? Yeah. Damn. And now you, the rest of your life, you, that wish I could just tell my nigga I was tripping. I apologize. Yeah.
I don't want to hear that quote on Instagram.
But I'm going to say this, though, like, because I got to be harsh with this shit. I'm only saying that for the motherfuckers that I really value and I appreciate. If I'm not fucking with you, bro, I really don't appreciate the relationship. I don't give a damn what the fuck we had in life. I don't give a shit. But my nigga, if I came at you wrong, nigga, tell me. You can't, I feel away, bro. All right, bro. I apologize, my nigga. It's that simple.
Because, bro, some relationships meaning like, if I was cool with a nigga in middle school, right? I still got the memories.
Yeah.
You part of my story. But when I run across you again later on in life, I'm not trying to pick up where we left off in middle school. But I know you and speak to you. What's up, bro? That's my nigga. I remember. We gonna laugh at, man, remember that time you such. Fact. I don't gotta bring you over here, though, into the grown-up me.
Right.
We probably don't even mesh like that. Yeah, we grew apart. Right. And we were supposed to.
But I still pull up on you here and there. Like, I pulled up on one of our partners that, you know, he got fucked off and doing all his life shit. And I just pulled up on, let the nigga tell me his stories. Like, it wasn't even about nothing. Like, just listen to the nigga.
Yeah.
He didn't want you to listen, bro. He didn't want too much of nothing.
Yeah.
I'm on borrowed time. I ain't got time.
Y'all been saying, call me on the phone. Yeah, we can talk about this. I ain't pulling
it. I don't need to pull it. I'll pass it. You know the situation, you see the nigga, you like,
that's
you know what I'm saying? Like, damn.
Then when I see you, bro, I'm busting that nothing. I done bust the cone on some family members before. At the bus stop, I'm damn, man. I know this nigga look like he going for. I'm gonna be going to do, bro. It's up. Yeah.
I did that shit before.
Bro, look like he going to the north. Yeah. You like, man, I want to get a nigga ride, but knowing my luck, you ain't going up the street, bro. Nah. You got three buses to get.
you going to somewhere on the north side.
Deep in the
north.
Yeah.
Fucking my daddy, bro.
It's 5 o'clock. Get in, bro.
My daddy got some horses over there, bro. He said I can have them if I go check on them, but it's deep off in Fifth Ward. You like,
I gotta stop at the feed store.
Yeah.
That's the type of shit I run across, bro. That's why I have to just stand firm on what I believe in and be like, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna keep my head straight and act like I don't see you, bro. Yeah, I'm sorry.
What about me to call you? I seen you, see?
I don't answer.
Yeah.
I ain't answering. I'm sorry. I'm just
but I seen you. You call, I see your number. No, sir.
Yeah. Even if I didn't see you, you calling me randomly out the blue, my anxiety won't let me answer because I think you need something. You want to hold something.
Mm-hmm.
Or either you call it with bad news.
That's a fact.
Bro, such and such and check. Man, I'm not trying to hear that shit, bro. I don't want to hear that.
That shit is annoying. I'm not going to lie. I know. It's cool you giving me information today. I hate the motherfucker that's the bearer of bad news. You every always got you bad news, bro.
No,
like,
bro, no.
But why you can't never tell me no good shit? Man, you heard what happened to such and such?
Why check? Bro.
It's always the one nigga either bearer of bad news or the one female.
And they know the worst news, too.
Yeah.
I got split in half, bro.
What, nigga? They chopped that boy up in 52 pieces. God damn, bro.
It's something, think to his mama, like, nah, bro, I don't want to hear that no shit like that, bro. I'm good, bro, for real.
Everybody got that one nigga they like,
though. I swear to God, bro. I know I got
you heard? Yeah. Man, fuck you, bro. Heard shit, I'd rather see it on Facebook. You not finna exaggerate this story to me, bro.
Nigga say you heard.
You know, because you see them online all the time. What they, you know they first line. I'm fucked up by this
one. Yeah, this one fucked me up.
This one.
Nah, not him. Nah, we laughing, but be lying, though. That's what they do, bro. This one fucked me up, bro.
Damn, not you. Who was supposed to be then? Man, we all, you know what it is.
Come on.
Damn.
Y'all
some hoes. I got a quick question for y'all. So, y'all probably got to think deep about this, but what you think y'all biggest life lesson is to yourself?
Damn, that was deep.
Biggest
life lesson?
Yeah. Mine ain't that hard, bro, but...
Yeah, nigga, because you've been
thinking about... Yeah, that's what I'm saying. No, I'm saying... Well, no, I'm
you
saying...
You got deep, man.
No, I'm saying that. Ass.
You got to call me with this one on the phone.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, I need to tell y'all. Yeah, man,
he ain't telling nigga nothing.
No, that's what I'm telling
this
y'all.
One, this one came with a Scantron. Both one. I'm... Shit, nigga, what?
This multiple choice?
Yeah, I don't know.
No, y'all ain't got an answer, bro, but for real.
Nah. Because
what I say in mine is like, what I'm saying mine is not that hard is because I'm saying it's like just some regular shit. It's like, what I thought of mine is, bro, I just needed to get my life together, bro, before I ever got in a relationship.
Mm.
That's a good one.
Mm. That's like, period.
That's cold.
That's tough. Yeah, you right about that one.
You know, that's just some simple shit, bro, but.
Mm-hmm. That's most men. That should be a life lesson, bro.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah.
On some real shit, bro.
Yeah.
Get your life together before you try to add somebody to your shit.
Yeah.
That's even, like, when it comes to having a kid.
Yeah.
Man, I know that nut feel good and all that, bro. But, hey, listen, bro. Get you together before you add anybody to your equation, bro.
Boy, you don't want to struggle
with a kid.
Because you
have zero. How you going to add?
You ain't really got somebody like-minded and it ain't... That you know, you'll never know, but if you ain't see that person on that same trajectory with you, like you trying to build as I'm trying to build, then you need to focus on yourself. You need to get it for your own self. Because, it, like, say, Vince, you in the trenches with it, y'all both broke, and the mother was like, hey, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna go be this, I'm gonna be a welder. And the female tell you now, you know what? I'm gonna go do x-rays.
Yeah.
So we both going to trade somewhere.
Yeah, thanks.
But if you in there somewhere and that female working Walmart, and you trying to go do a trade, you need to focus on yourself, bro, and cut ties.
All right, I think mine is nothing go as planned. That's how, because I live my life like that. Like, don't get me wrong, I still set goals,
nah,
I still accomplish shit, and I still be like, this is what I'm going to do, and it get done, but the journey there, the journey can't be planned. I might have steps that I'm going to follow to get me there.
Yeah.
But when that bitch start going like this, I just ride the ride, bro. Because, nigga, if you think that it's going to go like this getting there, and that bitch go that way and come back, you going to stop. By the time it go that way, you quit. Hell nah, this ain't going like I thought it was going to go.
And that's hard.
That's life.
That's a hard thing to tell, motherfucker. Everything ain't going to go as planned.
I don't give a damn if you just wanted a job. Nigga, you might have everything lined up, and then they call back and we went with somebody else. What the fuck?
You done had that. You had that first check lined up.
Yeah,
I get what you're saying. You
picture that 3-4 times, bro. You like, hell yeah, I done got this one. It's
that first
time.
Check line, you already looking at them Paulas online. Yeah. Like, shit. I'm finna get that white boy, nigga.
They only want 35.
Yeah,
I say too much.
Yeah,
I got that
check.
I'm so tired of the mitt right now.
Yeah, you telling your gal and everything.
Yeah,
oh yeah, we good now.
Now
you got that call early that morning. You like, shit, they should be calling me by Friday.
Yeah, you must be
like, funny, bro. They should be calling me by
Friday.
So you done woke up in the morning. Hey, is this something? Yeah, how you doing? You think you happy?
Yeah.
Well, you got to come by here.
You standing up walking on the phone.
That's when you get sleepy.
I'm going to just put down, bro. Like,
nah.
Hey, that's a hard one.
Shit,
man,
I get rough for me, bro.
Yeah.
I've been through that shit. That's hard, bro. But nah, I'm going to say...
that nigga hit with that one, bro.
Yeah,
I didn't count that money before I got it.
For real.
I'm up now.
But the reason I was saying about the...
you feel the joke.
Nah, don't get in that relationship without yourself. Because you know them females, they hit you quick with that. It ain't all about the money.
Yes, it is, bitch.
And then as soon as you get in that rough little bitch, it's going to be with the nigga with the money.
Yeah, keep it real with me.
The money. Yeah, your birthday that came around, I ain't got no money. Now you a broke ass bitch. God damn.
They showing you what everybody else did. Look what he bought up. Bitch, I'm knocking that bitch. Get that fucking phone out of my face. I'm broke to the hole. What are you talking about?
I'm sleeping.
I'm waking up. I'm waking up today. It's slept all day.
It's 2 in the evening.
You should be up trying to fill out a fucking application, bitch. I'm tired. I ain't got no energy for that, bro.
Oh, shit.
Nah, Nah, but I'm gonna say, like, appreciate. I'm gonna say the learning lesson is appreciate the accomplishment as you get to where you're going. Cause a lot of that, a lot of the times, like when a nigga was coming up and accomplishing a little small goal, nigga wasn't trying to celebrate it or nothing. You just going on to the next thing. So my shit would be like, let me appreciate the step that I took more, yeah, and stop getting big out of it and saying like, you know what? I need to, I gotta have this right now. Yeah. Instead of, you know, this little small goal I accomplished, let me go celebrate it or do whatever I gotta do with it because
it was a step forward.
Yeah, it was a step forward. Yeah. So that'll be my thing, like, appreciate it, the journey more.
Because the perspective, it's really about the perspective, bro. This is why my thinking have me so out of touch with people. I think this is why I got anxiety so motherfucking bad, because my way of thinking is so different from people. It'll be like you said, it falls into that. Like, you finally came up and got your own apartment. You should be happy. You shouldn't be talking about where your apartment at, yeah, how small it is. Bro, you doing the same shit in your apartment that everybody else doing in theirs. Mm-hmm. It's storage space. Mm-hmm. This is where you store your fucking energy. This is where you store your belongings, your safe haven, your food, your clothes, this. Lay down, get your rest. That's all your house and apartment is
we
for.
We all going to sleep at the same time.
Like, seriously, you locking your door, laying down,
getting the same
and you dying for 8 hours. Yeah. You don't know what the fuck happened with 8 hours.
And we was looking at this like wild animal shit. Like, you just went from the wild and you just got your cage.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. You, mm-hmm, you think them lines look at nigga? You heard Jeffrey bitch ass down there working at the circus, huh?
Jeff, oh.
Yeah, they feeding him good.
Yeah.
I ain't caught shit this month.
I always thought about that shit, though. Y'all ever wonder how them animals be feeling in the zoo, bro? When they just used to the wild,
nigga,
and they
nigga,
just...
Why you think they be pissed off?
And they just be stuck in that one little cage.
Them monkeys starting to show.
I know they eat.
Oh, son, you see that monkey grab that bitch back? Get your bitch ass
I seen one of them monkeys did me like this.
You see what they be doing to people? That, oh, y'all want to see something?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Y'all like looking at you. They're pouring up right on the bitch. Y'all want to watch? Y'all want to show, huh? Nigga, bend that bitch up and start pounding them.
I know they eating that good and shit.
And right in front of bitch kids, too. They go, oh, yeah, they think they grown up. Don't bring them to the zoo if you don't want to see this. Hey, take that line.
It be the women, she bouncing.
This monkey be riding their dick too.
I'm like, fuck a gorilla.
I'm digging hard.
This episode 20, we going platinum. We don't give a damn, bro. We going in on
that. That
gorilla steady bouncing. I'm looking.
That ass was jiggling too.
Yeah, I'm looking at that ass. What a gorilla ass. Nah, bro, but like, I ain't gonna lie, bro. I remember when I took my daughter to SeaWorld, that shit ran across my mind.
Just how they just be stuck in that same little spot for
Yeah, life. Like that's stupid. That's jail.
Yeah, jail.
Like for animals and shit, that shit like jail, bro. You got them doing that
in captivity,
doing tricks,
bro.
Whatever, yeah. And it's like,
yeah,
you look at the shit as a whole, like we get entertainment out of this shit. Yeah. Man, I'm
not soon as we go home, they get your ass back in that cage.
Yeah,
get your ass back.
Bitch.
Yeah.
For you don't
That's
eat.
How I go,
you man. Know what I'm saying?
That's why I was trying to explain to somebody, like, bro, we really just animals, but we just at the top of the food chain.
Yeah,
we
just
evolved
this sports thing.
Yeah, a lot of our mental is different, but a lot of the habitat is similar. So when he explained it, like, hey. When I say appreciate it more, he explained like you just your house and your apartment. We basically going through the same cycle,
yeah,
as a motherfucking animal. Because if you see a bird, they gonna make a bird's nest,
yeah,
and then all the birds are gonna make the same fucking bird's nest,
yeah.
Ain't no bird living no better than a nigga.
Nah,
bird.
Yeah.
We all living the fucking same.
I ain't never seen one looking just.
This boy got a live bird.
Where that boy get them sticks from?
Double deck a bird.
I ain't seen that shit before.
Nah, nigga, they right there. Like every
Every ant pile is the same. It's all them layers and floor, they all working. Like, that's why I said, like, we got this shit fucked up. Yeah. We got so far from being in touch with, like, our own nature. Everything is about how people feel, how is this, instead of just being naturally what we do and how we are, we don't even want to understand how naturally we supposed to be.
Right.
We go off what we think we should be, like, how we feel. This is why everybody going crazy, because the shit ain't normal. So everybody flipping out, going fucking crazy, they killing, they doing this and then the third, because you putting all these different, you know, stipulations and shit on relationships, on everything, and it's like,
this is why I was
telling the motherfucker, like, if we gotta try to understand each other, bro.
Right.
Do you want me to do what you want me to do, or do you want to understand why I'm doing what I'm doing? Right. Because I'm a fucking male, and you a fucking female.
Hold on. Let me cut you off, because I got to drop this in there, and you can continue to go.
I was done.
That was some shit that I was saying, like, as far as why are we, as a different species, the woman and the man, why are we so competitive these days? Can we go back to men being a man and women being a woman? Because you have a woman saying, well, y'all can do this and we can't do that.
Yeah.
Or a man say, hey, the female doing this, so we should be able to do that.
Yeah.
Why the fuck I want to be a woman?
Yeah.
I don't want to go call my name in no woman car. That's women shit.
It ain't that many. I think it's more the females. And let me tell you my idea from this. Society then gave these women too many safety valves and like safe havens. And think about it. Now they got so much fight in them, like, now. And ain't nothing wrong with it, because they needed it, because, like I said, you know how niggas are doing female, they're doing bad, nigga, like, because they a man, and they feel like, fuck it, you figure it out, and she really couldn't figure it out. So, they got it to where it's not like, oh, you can get you some house, and you can do this. So, the more she don't need the nigga, she can compete with the nigga now. But at first, when she needed the nigga, like, how am I gonna compete with a nigga that I need?
Right.
I don't need you no more, bro. Like, think about it. They keep giving them shit, but it's our doing to why they had to put them defense mechanisms up on us, bro. Okay. They had to put the child support up on us. They had to get them housing. They had to get them food stamps. They had to get them Plan Bs. They had to get them abortions. You feel me? Because you niggas doing them any kind of way.
Right.
And still be like, tell them, man, I can do what the fuck I want. So now, they like, yeah, nigga, you can't do me like that no more, nigga. I'm working at the... Bitch, I got money too. What we doing? Right. So now they straight back for revenge.
Right.
I seen how my mama was done. Bitch, you got me fucked up. I ain't going out like my auntie and mama.
Get back.
So that's what it is.
Get back time. But this, and then another thing is, everything you hit with that. Another thing is the woman is more exposed to a bigger audience now. You know what the fuck fucking with you now. Like, you know, like, nigga, it's some niggas on my body right now.
Straight up.
Nigga, you got me fucked up. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I just keep me in a high.
Yeah, like, you know, at first, before they had the internet and shit, it was like, nigga, grandpa could go have his bitch that stay on this cone and this cone.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't no exposing, like, that shit.
But you ain't been past the meat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Feel me?
So now they know. So now's the thing of, I want to be competitive with you, but I'm saying as a man, I still don't want to compete with you. Because if you doing all that shit steady, like, oh, as a man can do this, I still got to check you and put you in your place and be like, nah, you can't really do what I do. No, you know what I'm saying? Man. I can't really do what you do.
Yeah.
I don't want to do what you do. You born for what you born for, bro. Like, you born for what you born for. I'm born for what I'm born for. We have to respect that, bro.
Yeah.
You can't get me to think like you think. I got a dick. You got a pussy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You got a port of the life. I got the pistol.
They don't treat that like that.
Because men is out here.
And yeah, they don't treat that like that.
They fucking all these women, and they want to say women can't fuck men, or we being cow hoes.
Yeah.
Well, bitch, you can go make the same money as me, and I still got to put up chunk of the bread for our bills, because I'm a man.
Yeah.
I'm a hunter. That's my primal instinct, is to take care of my significant other.
And like what you was talking about last time, bitch, I can go put this baby.
I'm mean.
Yeah.
I'm not sweet and nice. I'm mean for no reason sometimes.
Sometimes.
I'm pulling this testosterone. I ain't had a scrap in 10 years.
Yeah.
I'm looking.
Yeah.
And I can go have this baby, and burn out.
Yeah.
A nigga can put that baby in you and burn out. Yeah. Your life is it's fucked up.
Yeah. Right? And now you need somebody to come in and take over that spot, bro. Yeah.
Like, a man.
You
know? A man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So basically what I'm trying to say is
it takes a village.
That's the wrong answer. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's stick to our gender roles and let's stop competing. That's what I want to say to the women. If you saying,
you know who started that though?
I think we too.
Them ugly bitches. Them ugly man looking bitches who wasn't getting put up, they had to get in the field. Them the woman warrior.
I seen
they the ones that started that. They, let me see that hammer.
I seen one that was a plumber. She was hot at the work.
Seen her ass crack out.
It was a BBL on it.
It was a thong though.
Yeah. It started with them bitches at them chemical plants. That's where it started at. That was been a rough hole. They started getting that bread. They 20-something hour and they start shitting on niggas. That was with them,
I'm
gonna say when the hemis started off, I'm putting them hemis up to the...
Bitch, I'm scat back
Yeah.
Fuck with the nigga. I don't think we gonna get past that, though. I don't think it's ever gonna go back.
Nah, it ain't.
Nah, it's too far gone, bro.
You just gotta find the ones that still with that shit. Yeah. Like, that understand this shit could all go left tomorrow, and I know I'm gonna need a nigga.
Right.
Feel what I'm saying? Like, the ones that's live for the moment, they feel like, man, fuck, bitch, I'm
because I don't mind your disadvantages, is what I'm saying. I don't mind that you can go fucking key my car, and if I'm doing this, a bitch shit. I don't mind that. I don't mind that when we come, we gotta pay bills, we both make $100,000, that I gotta put up 70, you can put up 30. I don't mind it because I'm a man. But I really don't mind.
I know me. It's never 50-50 with me.
That's what I'm saying.
I gotta do majority because I'm the nigga.
I'm a man.
I'm just saying you're gonna do something to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But it's never that 50-50, I don't wanna do no 50-50.
This shit. All right, wait, we
gotta stop talking about this 50-50 shit.
No, what I'm saying about the rest is like, bro,
I think everybody just gotta live for their own shit.
That is
if I'm struggling and you,
that's what I mean,
that's just what it is.
I wasn't saying that so we could bring that up, because we already did establish that. We already know what that is, but I'm saying I know what you're talking about as far as that, and that's why you want, it's just something in you that make you want to do that.
Yeah. Right. So that what I'm saying.
It's something in you make you want to lock the door. Make you want to.
Yeah,
facts.
Nobody ever told you when you was walking on the motherfucking sidewalk to grab your gal and put on that
when
side.
You somewhere, bro, and you get a flat tire, you call, man, where your dumb ass at? I'm on my way.
Yeah.
But when I'm giving you your verbal action, a lot of people, and this is what I hate, a lot of females got so much wordy words to say when you giving them getting on their ass.
Yeah, I'm just trying to tell
you. Yeah, like, I'm, hey, say, bro, when you left out of here, bro, you left fucking the stuff on the thing, I had to throw that shit away.
Yeah.
Well, maybe if you would have took the time.
Just can't take it.
Just take what I'm saying, bro.
Because a lot of them didn't grow up with their daddy. So they don't know how a man talk to you.
Yeah.
They think you just being disrespectful, but I'm talking about a man. This how a man talk.
For real.
So, and I'm telling you, hey, bro, like, look, I ain't talking to you like a child, talking to you like a man.
And I'm not trying to disrespect you.
But that made me think about this, bro. Do women have OGs? Role models they look up to? Anybody? Who do y'all get advice from besides your fucked up ass mama?
Nobody.
Some of y'all got good mamas and they give up. But I'm saying, like, do you have a mentor as a woman?
Already.
You know how you can call your OG? Or be like, yeah, that nigga my OG. That nigga kind of like my big bro.
Yeah.
That nigga kind of raised me up. I know who to get the advice. I know who to go to. That ain't going to always take my motherfucking side.
Mm-hmm.
Nigga going to tell me right and wrong, hey, you out of line,
bro. I
don't
think they got that.
Do women have OG? I ain't never seen a woman with an OG.
Nah. They OGs is like...
The Instagram models, the celebrity.
That's why I said Ari and Jada.
I can't say Beyonce started it, but Beyonce be sitting their ass in the wrong direction sometimes, too. She's married with kids, but she gonna come out with a song shitting on niggas.
That's a song, though.
You know what I mean? But I'm just saying, that's
real life, though.
Yeah.
That's an entertainment.
In real life, we got OG niggas that you like, bro, that's my OG, that nigga that put me on game. But I say the women is so damn competitive, they can't even get that woman that card. They did have an OG.
That's what it is. Because you know, the old school lady still competing with the young
female.
That's why she ain't giving up no game. Bitch need to learn for herself. Because she want to fuck the same nigga she fucking.
Yeah.
You hit me.
Ooh, yeah.
That be about to get flagged.
Yeah.
Nah, seriously, yeah. When you think about it, nigga, they women are very competitive. I watched, nigga, my mama was waiting to jump on my sister.
That first jump
she
on?
She was waiting for him to grow up. What you say?
Y'all knock that bitch head between the flower pot. He didn't knock their head.
They so competitive though, bro.
Yeah, bitch, fucking, but they ready to do that first jump on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't understand what this shit about, bro. What that shit started at, the competitiveness, bro.
That's just in their blood.
Yeah. That's why they gotta go and get up out that highs when they turn about 16.
Cause you see, when they.
Oh, yeah.
They, bro, they so. Women are so in tune with, like, the universe and shit to where they all go together and get their periods and shit around the same time.
Yeah.
And all you hear is a bunch of squawk.
Yeah.
That's why they gotta get out of there.
As soon as she come up to you, what's your sign?
Yeah.
They saw a tune in the universe, they go, you know,
I don't know. Hey, I swear, bro, once a week I'm paying mediator with my daughter and my BM, bro.
That's nice.
I'm studying like, well, you know, she was. I'm being so tired.
Your daughter
shit,
ready
bro.
To book and your baby mama ready to jump on.
Yeah,
ready. My baby mama already did that jump on.
If you don't get this bitch,
so they already got to understand. Damn. I didn't see my daughter dusted. I'm that first jump on. Huh?
I'm not gonna. I tell the truth. I'm like, I ain't gonna lie. You lost.
You said you didn't book.
Yeah. She got on your ass.
Yeah. I said I told you, bro. She gonna get on your ass.
Yeah. I told my daughter the same shit. She kept bugging. I said, all right, bro. You. Mama gonna dust
you,
bro.
I can't
say
you.
Then when she got dusted, I said, bro, I told you, bro.
Yeah.
I can help, bro. Yeah, she ain't get dusted bad. She just got like a quick.
She got jumped.
Yeah.
No.
I seen her acting right then. I'm a, you got right now.
She is, ma'am?
Yeah.
See her come back with the glasses. Yeah. Where you get the glasses from? You beat up to
her. She not gonna manage to the room.
Nah, you hit me with something on that, though, because them women. Do not have no OGs, bro. Like, the OG, the only person that can get advice for them is their mama, like you said.
Yeah,
I ain't never seen no woman. But most of, can I cut them a little bell, though? Because like he said, the older women be competitive, bro.
Nah,
like, I had seen a female that said, like, I came in a, and I was trying to just learn some game. She came into the workplace, and I was just trying to learn some game from the older manager, but...
Mean.
Seen a young, fine thing come in there.
Mean.
Shut her down.
Mean.
Mean to her.
Mean than a bitch. I don't know why she act like that. Because you the young, fine bitch. She probably was once the young, fine bitch in here.
We came in the next day, ain't no tights coming in. It was her that rolled it, bro. She young, I don't wear no tights no more to work.
Her name was in parentheses. No tights, Catherine.
Ashley.
Nah, look. But that... You even see it going in the church house.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She come in there dressed like that. Man, that girl just got a shape. She can't help the way that dress hood go.
She got on, yeah.
For real.
You getting older now and you
didn't
get
nobody watching you no more. Yeah, get your ass
so school hiding, hating. They hiding, hating. When that young fine thing coming in, they going to be mean to her.
Mm-hmm.
You need to learn this because they ain't trying to be like, nah, you know, you got to come in and know. It's just that air, but oh, man, she pretty. You keep hearing this and you getting madder and madder. Bitch, it's time for you to
go home
put some respect on Father Time.
Yeah.
To get real acquainted with him, cause you're up there with him.
Cause I said this on the last part, I believe is one thing is men. Okay, that's like when the women say, and I know we all heard this. When I post a sexy picture, I don't post it for the men. I post it for myself. That's for me. That's not for woo-to-woo, this, that, and third. And that's not for you. That's for me. Okay, you saying that, but if you don't get no likes, you're mad. You let me update this phone.
Now, you know what they're gonna do? This got deleted, but who deleted it? Why my shit never randomly got deleted? This somehow got deleted.
Yeah.
We know it didn't get
yeah,
much. Y'all was gonna do, bro.
Yeah, it ain't. But a man. We don't attention seek.
Lost files. No, it ain't. You bringing
it
back.
Yeah.
We don't attention seek is basically what I'm trying to say.
Nah.
Our thing is, like, we sit up here and talk about grinding and appreciating the steps and all this because we go chase the sack. So when the young hot nigga come up, we like, hey, that boy on their business. We go drop him some game.
Because you see you in it.
Yeah.
That be, you kind of live through that little nigga.
Yeah.
You like, nigga, I like what you got going. And you live through that nigga. Like, you don't try to... Be like, hell nah, I can't compete with you, young nigga.
Yeah.
Let me go drop young bro some game.
Especially if we doing what we doing, making the bread, and the young nigga come in early making bread, you like, boy, you start out
you
early.
You want it quick, but no, hold on, though. It's some old hating ass niggas out there.
It
felt it a lot when I felt it, but it's just that my aura let an old nigga know I ain't playing with him.
Yeah.
School, I'm going to show you the difference in the age gap.
Yeah.
But school, come on, school.
I'll punish you.
Yeah, I'll punish you, bro. But I respect my elders. I'm a real, but I pull a nigga to the side and be like, say, don't play with me, bro.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what I'm talking about, nigga. You them little sideways right. Shit. And I know, nah, we not doing
that. I'll check your ass from 30 to 80.
Yo,
I'll pull an old school to the side,
yeah.
Bro.
Yeah.
Say, hey,
you need to chill.
Watch out, you, yeah, bro. Yeah, don't. I ain't one of them, bro. Yeah, don't. Yeah. You ain't gonna talk.
I seen a video where a nigga did exactly what I did. He had a trainer.
Yeah.
Nigga put that bitch in park. Like, get out of here over the beach. I did the same shit to a nigga, bro.
I swear to God, me too.
I say, hey, bro, put it in park because you're not gonna talk to me like I'm crazy. Yeah. What you trying to do?
He training you.
He training me, yeah, but the trainers, bro, they used to talk to you crazy back in the day.
For real. Yeah, that's changed.
I was going to beat the fuck out of this. Man, I'll never forget that shit, bro. I'm way in Oklahoma, bro. I'll never forget it. But, yeah, them old school niggas will hate on you. They'll hate.
Yeah,
you
ain't lying.
They'll hate. You coming in. And they, what they hate is, you. They journey, you got on it earlier than them. See how we said it and we respect it? They'll look at it and be more like, this nigga getting this bread at that age, young. I ain't get on the
young dog. I expect this from a white nigga or a Mexican nigga or something. Come on, black nigga.
Nah, hey, black niggas worse than them.
Niggas, cause these niggas was naturally nerds, bro.
Yeah.
Like, you a G. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but the thing with women, it's be like, that little young bitch, fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
When it's an older nigga.
They know they nigga gonna look at that fine bitch.
Mm-hmm. A nigga with paper. Bro, first of all, a G'd up nigga with some paper. If he got a little bitch, he in her mind already.
Yeah.
So she ain't even looking past him. And if she is, it's probably for a brief, oh, he handsome. Mm-hmm. And get back to her nigga, because he a G'd up, money-making ass nigga. Yeah. So he ain't worried about the young nigga coming up, because he know, oh, my bitch ain't even got eyes for no young nigga.
Yeah.
She on me.
Yeah.
But if he, when the old broad come and she see that little young bitch coming up, my nigga will fuck the shit out of her.
Yeah. Yeah.
So let me keep going.
Or whatever nigga in his office that was fucking, I know what he finna do.
Yeah.
You finna attack this nigga.
Yeah. And she mad at you all of a sudden for some reason is dropping a stack of papers on your thing. Get it done by 12. It's 3 days worth
of. As soon as you walk out of the breath, bitch. That was for real, dog.
Oh, shit.
Poor, she spread rumors about the young bitch up there and shit.
But speaking of that, though, bro, I want to ask y'all one question, bro. I want to ask y'all this. I seen Blac Chyna getting her stuff taken down, all the little cellulite and all that. Do y'all think the BBL era is coming to an end?
I don't think it's coming to an end. It's over for me, though.
Remember, like you just said, they don't do it for us. So they going to keep doing it.
They do it for the crown.
Niggas been saying, like, y'all need to stop with this shit. This shit ridiculous.
Yeah.
You done seen some ridiculous shit, so, and you be like, well, who let you go do this?
For real.
Where your OG?
They ain't got no fucking OG. Where's the OG? Where the OG?
You got to step up and talk
and
to y'all.
And then the nigga told her no when she looked at him and said, I ain't doing this for you.
For real.
I don't think it's gonna be over.
That's hard, see.
I don't think it's over. But for me, I'm into the fitness, bro.
So she jog all day so she can. Come on, Wayne.
Ooh, yeah.
Come on, Wayne.
Hey, bro. Hey, listen,
I'm into that, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
Man, I ain't gonna lie, bro.
I'm into that right now. I ain't.
It's easy to, in that gym though, to get tricked too. They done blended the two.
The BBL
was in that gym working out.
No shit.
Mm-hmm. And they done put some muscle behind there, and them started to look good.
Bro, I'm starting to see them Mexicans and them white girls coming in the gym where I'm in, bro.
Oh man, them Mexicans be
lined
up. They in there.
Mexicans.
Bro, I'm up in that baby one time. I had to tell her everything I was looking at because I ain't even want to feel like I was doing nothing wrong. Bro. I'm looking at her with me.
Yeah.
I'm looking at her.
Yeah, I'm going to say she's
probably shit. They coming in the end, though.
Yeah.
Like, bro, I'm trying to work out, bro. Seriously. Yeah. Like, chill the fuck out, bro.
Then they got that sexy workout outfit with the tights with the matching top.
But why you see the workout, the one that look like boy shorts.
Yeah.
Hey, you got it going on, well, for real. Yeah, like, seriously.
That's disrespectful, bro.
Seriously.
You took it too far, like, I'm up here trying to work out for real, bro.
Yeah,
it's not the strip club.
It's not.
Come on, man.
It's not.
They got the skirts on and everything.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm... I gotta trick myself into thinking that that pussy stank. You done keep your dick from getting hard in the gym. You done got that treadmill with a bitch ass was jiggling, bro. You standing looking. You got to look at that shit stank.
I'm throwing it. Bro, this nigga over the day. You got to, bro. You stand it looking.
So, overall, y'all saying coming to an end or not? It's not.
I don't think it's coming to an end.
I think that the older bitches, health-wise,
are coming to an end. Because some of them older ones, bro, be looking like a baked potato, just stuffed, bro.
Yeah, that shit look bad. I don't
like that. The older women are starting to take their shit out. And I guess they kind of starting to realize, like, man, I don't need this shit.
But how does it look when you take it out? Does it go back regular or is it going to be looking lumpy? I ain't seen nobody.
I seen Kate Michelle.
Yeah, she still look like. Because she already had a shape.
Yeah, she had a shape. She don't look. Yeah. The thing about it is, I think the ones that's taking it out is the ones that really was already kind of shaped. Some of them, no.
That's why
I said, like, it ain't coming to an end because some females really
need it. They got their life saved.
They really need it, bro. For real. And I salute the ones that really needed it, bro, because, yeah, you was built hard.
Like a sack of laundry, yeah.
Yeah.
But the females who need that, I found it out. I see what they doing. The female that I'm looking at, because it's some females, this is what they're doing. I'm giving y'all the game. These females, they really ain't dropping them stacks like y'all think they dropping them stacks on them BBLs and the veneers and all that. What they doing is they getting a CPN.
Snitch.
They getting a CPN and then they apply for care credit, bro. Care credit.
So you gotta have good credit score to get through.
No! Listen.
I'm studying this. I'm finna cap credit, bro. No, wait.
When you get the CBN, CBN get you a clean slate credit score clean. Mm-hmm. Now they taking that CBN and then they going to apply. The care credit is going to be a credit line that's going to go through all the little medical things and get you by 25 racks. So they going to clean up veneers, BBL, titties done.
In the Mercedes Benz.
In the
Benz.
Yeah.
So I'm putting y'all on, man. Okay, so come back and follow, subscribe, and Big Trouble, because we put y'all on over
here. See, you shouldn't have gave it all up.
Give $1 million worth of game.
Yeah.
I knew it was something, bro.
It's coming to
I'm like, how everybody affording this, bro? I thought it was PPP.
Nah, that PPP. Some of them went through it.
With the PPP.
But a lot of them care credit.
Let me look this up.
Look it up, bro. Care credit, bro.
I'm finna apply. I'm finna apply care credit, bro. Wow, bro. I can't believe this shit.
This nigga's stupid.
I just be trying to put them on, bro. Yeah, bro. They can come back. Yeah. You know, Big Trouble. We ain't just. Yeah. We ain't no woman bastard.
We finna go down to 90 subscribers.
We ain't woman bastards, bro.
Damn, baby. You stupid.
I had to give them that, though, see, because a lot of them. We ain't no woman bashers.
Nah, making sure he insert that in.
Fuck them, bro. Y'all go grind and get out of here. Grind and get y'all shit.
So what y'all want to do? Y'all want to talk about the last little...
And get a buyer?
Last little nigga that got his top chop?
No.
We're going to get that to that on the extend up.
Yeah.
Take us out.
He said no.
I want to get y'all take on the Troy Air shit.
Okay.
Y'all follow the little shit? Troy Air took the stand and the shit.
You want to add my personal opinion?
I seen him take the stand, but I don't know what old dude did. I got
it. Tax on?
Yeah.
Tax on. Murked his bodyguard.
In front of
his best friend, though.
Yeah, like in the club. Friend. Like, they came in there, them niggas was beefing. Which is really some shit Tax on was starting.
He created.
He was on that nigga ass. And they ran across each other. And the nigga drew down. I don't know if they start scrapping first or something, but Tag Stone drew down and popped his bodyguard. He murked him.
In the
and
club.
And he popped Troy Ave, but Troy Ave
took the gun from the nigga.
Took the gun from him and started busting back. Some more people got hit, but they got caught on camera. Troy Ave was caught on camera because he came out of the room busting. Mm-hmm. But
that's why he was locked up and shit.
Yeah, but he got out or whatever. But and then
Now they went to, they go on the court, they go on the trial behind it, because they was, how it looked was they was trying, they were putting the murder on Troy Ave and shit. But now he went, he took the stand or whatever, you know, and everybody, like, it's a big deal.
They're trying to say he a snitch.
Yeah, I mean, he told, basically, for real.
But if you ask me, like, bro, you not for the, I'm not for the take no murder, you partner, partner. No, I'm not doing that, bro.
You pulled the ham out on me.
You pulled the ham, and I took it from you. Yeah. But you want me to keep it, G? Now I ain't gonna hold you nothing. We gonna treat this like the mob, nigga. Yeah. We ain't treating this like no black shit, nigga. I took that from you, and I, nigga, I got
now, you know my thing. You know my thing about that shit is, y'all niggas beefing. You really expected that nigga to grant you some clemency?
Some loyalty? Like,
but my, this another thing. You fucking idiot. You basically made the nigga tell on you. Why would you do this shit in the club? I could see if y'all ran into each other in the streets, some shit went down, and this whatever happened. I would have called that nigga like a snitch then. But this shit is like basically on camera. Everybody was there.
To say nothing.
You made the nigga tell on you, bro. How you gonna pop up like that inside of a club? Right. That shit be dumb. And then you think the nigga supposed to keep it real. No, I ain't seen nothing.
Okay, so if it's on camera in the club, why did he have to even stand up and tell?
Because the camera got the after when he came out.
Yeah,
they was inside of like a little green room or something.
Yeah.
Oh, he came
and backstage. So when he came out, he had the gun. Remember, he shot already in his leg and shit, but he took the gun and stretched. And he came out and he was busting at the nigga. Mm-hmm. So it looked like your nigga dead, you coming out with the gun. So it looked like you brought the gun in there and you killed the nigga in the midst of you shooting. Yeah. So all the charges were straight on him.
Yeah.
Until people start
like
saying
he killed his own partner.
They were trying to put his partner's body on him and shit.
Yeah, nah, bro.
But then again, like he said, the shit started from Tax Stone saying that on his podcast that the nigga Troy Ave wasn't everything he say he was.
And he was trolling the shit out of him.
He was trolling him, bro.
He was on his ass about everything.
You was doing a lot of that saying that nigga wasn't like that, and the nigga showed you he was like that. But now you want some loyalty from him and his partner dead. And they putting it on him. No, I don't owe you no loyalty.
All I'm saying, bro, if you a street nigga, bro, and you want to get into some street shit, do it in the streets. That's why they call the streets. You went to a fucking establishment like a club and then think a nigga supposed to be on some street shit. It's on camera. It's too many witnesses. What the fuck do you, like, y'all niggas make niggas tell on y'all.
I wouldn't give a damn if we was in the streets. If you ran up on me,
I know, what I'm saying is I'm still two street niggas, like regular street niggas that just, it's on site, whatever. That on site mean, nigga, I run into you in traffic, we meet on the block, and whatever we do it, we do it. You can't catch a nigga in Walmart when it's on, and then be like, man, that nigga told on me. Bro, you about to, we in Walmart. Nigga, what the fuck do you mean?
So you want, and then you want me to, if this shit go down and I lose this case, you want me to be in jail and people think that I killed my partner that I didn't kill?
And you gonna be free.
You gonna be free.
And nigga about to keep it real with you and y'all enemies. I don't get these niggas, bro.
We going back to this street shit, bro. This street shit dumb as fuck, bro.
Let me end it, because I'm going to end it. We going to end it in the statement. Troy Ave statement. God is great and the paper straight.
We out of here.